Data governance maturity model has 5 stages. What are they and what does each one of them do?
So as I mentioned in the overview, there's 5 stages to our data governance maturity model. In the initial stage, typically that's oriented around ETL and data governance. There really isn't much policy setting at the top level, but people are trying to assess quality in their respective projects. That leads to the next stage, which is the project stage. Typically, that's when users self-identify as data quality buyers and users. They're trying to get some standardization around rule definition and execution, but they don't really have a formal data governance program at that time. We moved into the manage stage. That's when the user typically is getting into master data management, which is the subject of this conference, typically oriented around what we used to call analytical MDM, which is basically driving standardization for customer identity or domain identity on a single silo. As they start to move more into the operational stage, they become more interested in multi-domain governance. And at that point, they're typically spinning up a governance program, formalizing standards and practices, aligning cross-functionally using that governance program, and starting to develop some competencies around what we call enterprise data stewardship, which is the capacity to formalize, define, collaborate around policy standards. Then when they get to the fifth stage, the strategic stage, that's the point in which we start seeing organizations leveraging data for strategic assets, developing new products and new offerings, particularly data products and offerings, around the utilization of their enterprise data.
In which one of them companies are today, and is there any difference between companies in Brazil and in other markets?
That's a great question. Well, you know, as we talked about, the customers that we've surveyed self-assess at less than 2 in terms of their overall data governance maturity. But that seems apparent when you compare data governance as a competency in typical in the enterprise to corresponding competencies like, you know, their financial competency or their HR competencies, which are typically much more heavily invested, both in terms of process and tooling, and much more predictable in terms of outcomes, right? So I still think as an industry and as a set of practitioners, we have a way to go in terms of improving the relative maturity around data governance practices in the market.
But did companies realize the importance of data governance, and why should they be aware of it? Yeah.
That is a great question. And I forgot to answer your second question, which is in Brazil, we have some anecdotal assessment around governance practices. We find that they typically fall in line around the general standard for the organization. So why should customers care about data governance? Well, there's certain classes of customer, for example, highly regulated industries, such as financial services in the United States and Europe, that don't really have to ask that question because they have to spin up data governance programs in response to the regulatory regimes from their banking authorities. So a very typical case, for example, would be Fannie Mae, which was the case study we watched right before I came on board. Fannie Mae is a financial institution, but it's also a government entity. It is the last line of defense in the United States for all mortgage-backed security defaults. So it is the government's primary instrument for protecting the economy from a major meltdown like the one that we had in 2008. They have a very, very robust governance practice because they have to report their finances to the government every quarter. Other banks that we've seen that, you know, Informatica is widely utilized in financial services have very similar programs. The interesting aspect of it is in customers that are outside of heavily regulated industries and what they're doing to spin up their governance programs. We find is that often customers in retail, healthcare, public sector, some of the insurance customers we talked about are very, very interested in finding ways to get more leverage out of their data. either directly by, you know, essentially producing data as a service type offerings, or often by utilizing that data in a more optimized way in various business processes and getting more out of those business processes. So those are all drivers for why a company might consider establishing and maintaining a governance program over time.
And do you think can we expect more about companies realize this importance and adopting some tools to manage this data governance from now on?
That's a great question. Well, certainly, I think that there's two ways you can look at it, right? There's carrots and there's sticks, right? So the banks are responding to the sticks, right? If they don't provide essential oversight to their risk management practices, and that's essentially a data governance practice, they'll have to retain more capital, which will cost them in their bottom lines, right? For other organizations, the opportunity there is more around the carrot, right? Which is, I can leverage this data to drive additional offerings, to upsell my customers. I can optimize my data utilization, so I'm not paying as much for data subscriptions as they otherwise would. And the other point I want to make is this isn't necessarily like a binary thing. Responding to governance, regulatory compliance initiatives in financial services, healthcare, and other highly regulated industries is certainly an important, it's an important precursor to spinning up a governance program. But even those customers are interested in leveraging their governance practices and infrastructure downstream to optimize their reuse of the data and to get more value out of the data. So it's kind of both end for those customers.